समझदार टोपी वाला। एक दिन एक गरीब टोपी वाला एक छोटे से गांव में टोपियां बेच रहा था। वो धूप में घूम घूम कर बहुत थक गया था, इसलिए एक बड़े पेड़ की छांव में उसने अपनी टोपियों की गठरी रखी और सो गया। जब वो सो रहा था तो उस पेड़ पर रह रहे बंदर नीचे उतरे और उसकी गठरी में से रंग बिरंगी टोपियों को अपने सर पर पहनकर पेड़ पर चढ़ गए। कुछ देर बाद जब टोपी वाले की नींद खुली तो उसने देखा कि सारी टोपियां बंदरों ने पहन रखी हैं। वो उन पर चिल्लाया, अरे वो टोपियां मेरी हैं, मुझे वापस दे दो। लेकिन बंदर वापस उस पर खर्राने लगे। ठीक उस समय उसे एक उपाय सूझा। उसने अपनी टोपी उतारी और जमीन पर फेंक दी। टोपी वाले ने जैसा किया वैसा ही सारे बंदरों ने अपने सर पर से टोपी उतारी और जमीन पर फेंक दी। टोपी वाले ने अपनी सारी टोपियां इकट्ठी की और गठरी में बांध कर खुशी खुशी वहां से चला गया।
The clever cap seller. One day, a poor cap seller was selling his caps in a small village. He was very tired, so he set down the bundle and fell asleep under a big tree. While he slept, the monkeys from the tree came down, opened the bundle of caps and wore them. After some time, the cap seller woke up. He saw that the monkeys had taken his caps, so he shouted,
"Hey! Those caps are mine. Give them back."
The monkeys shouted back, imitating him. This gave him an idea. He immediately threw his own cap on the ground. All the monkeys took off the caps and threw them on the ground. The cap seller happily collected his caps, tied his bundle, and went away. Moral: there is always a way out of every difficulty.
Monkeys were mischievous and imitating cap seller's act. There was no point in shouting at them, so the cap seller took advantage of the monkey's foolish act and got back his caps.
That means if we think carefully, there is always a way out of any difficulty.
Okay kids, let's learn few new words one by one.
Kids, repeat the words after us. Bundle.
Bundle means a collection of things wrapped together.
Bundle means a collection of things wrapped together.
Awake.
Awake means stop sleeping.
Awake means stop sleeping.
Who stole the caps?
Monkeys.
दो कौवे। एक दिन भोलू और गोलू के बीच विवाद खड़ा हो गया कि कौन उत्तम है। भोलू बोला,
मैं तुमसे उत्तम हूँ क्योंकि मैं तुमसे हट्टा कट्टा हूँ।
तो गोलू बोला,
नहीं नहीं, मैं उत्तम हूँ क्योंकि मैं तुमसे उम्र में बड़ा हूँ।
तो उन्होंने अपने बीच एक चुनौती रखी, जो अपनी चोंच में एक थैले में कुछ भर कर ऊपर उड़ेगा वही उत्तम है। गोलू बहुत धूर्त था, उसने अपने थैले में रुई की गेंदे भर ली और भोलू के थैले में नमक, और दोनों ने उड़ान शुरू की। देखते ही देखते गोलू ऊपर उड़ने लगा क्योंकि उसका वजन भोलू के वजन से कम था। बहुत कोशिश करने पर भी भोलू ऊपर नहीं उड़ पा रहा था। तभी अचानक बारिश होने लगी। रुई के गेंदे पानी में भीगने के कारण भारी हो गई, लेकिन भोलू के थैले में नमक पानी में घुलकर हल्का हो गया। अब भोलू ऊपर उड़ने लगा और उसने चुनौती भी जीत ली।
Once, two crows, Bholu and Golu, had a fight to prove their superiority.
I'm more superior, as I'm bigger in size.
No, I'm more superior to you, as I'm elder.
They decided on a challenge to fly with a bag in their beaks. The one who flies higher wins. Golu was a mean crow. He put cotton balls in his own bag and salt in Bholu's bag. The two crows then started flying. Soon Golu was flying higher than Bholu, as he was carrying a lighter weight. But Bholu could not fly higher than Golu due to the heavy weight. As the crows were flying, it started raining. The cotton ball soaked in water and became heavier. On the other hand, the salt got dissolved, making Bholu's bag very light. Now, Bholu began flying higher than Golu. Thus, Bholu won the challenge. Moral: cheaters will always be losers.
Cheating never lasts, my dear friends. If you try to cheat someone, most of the time you yourself will come in trouble.
You can never win by cheating in any game or life.
Okay, kids, let's learn few new words one by one.
Kids, repeat the words after us. Superiority.
Superiority means the quality of being excellent.
Superiority means the quality of being excellent.
Huge.
Huge means very big.
Huge means very big.
Who was the mean crow?
Golu.
Correct.
दो भिकारी. सोहन और मोहन दो भिकारी थे. वे दोनों एक बड़े मंदिर के बाहर अन्य भिखारियों के साथ खाना और पैसा भीख मांगते थे. सोहन लंगड़ा था और मोहन अंधा. एक दिन एक अमीर आदमी आकर बोला, मित्रों, मैंने अपने घर एक शानदार दावत का इंतजाम किया है. आप लोग जरूर कल मेरे घर आ जाना. सोहन और मोहन एक दूसरे की मदद के बगैर नहीं जा सकते थे. मोहन ने सोहन से कहा, दोस्त, अगर तुम मुझे रास्ता बताते जाओगे तो मैं तुम्हें अपनी पीठ पर बैठा कर ले चलूंगा. और दोनों ने ऐसा ही किया और जाकर दावत का मजा उठाया. दोनों बहुत खुश हुए.
The two beggars. Mohan and Sohan were two beggars. They used to sit near a temple gate to beg for money and food. Mohan was blind, so he could not see. Sohan was lame, so he could not walk. One day, a rich man came there.
Dear friends, I am having a big feast at my house. I request the both of you to come for lunch.
Mohan and Sohan decided to help each other and go for the feast.
I will carry you on my back if you show me the way.
Sohan agreed. Mohan carried Sohan on his back and both of them went to the feast. They enjoyed the excellent food and returned happily. Moral: we must always help each other.
Mohan and Sohan have shown us how to succeed in our goal by overcoming our inabilities.
No one in this world is complete or perfect. But if we help each other, together we can be perfect. Okay, kids, let's learn few new words one by one.
Kids, repeat the words after us. Beggar.
Beggar means a person who lives on alms.
Beggar means a person who lives on alms.
Lame.
Lame means disabled in the feet or legs.
Lame means disabled in the feet or legs.
Blind.
Blind means unable to see.
Blind means unable to see.
Feast.
Feast means a ceremonial dinner party.
Feast means a ceremonial dinner party.
Now tell me, who was blind?
Mohan.
Do bakriya. गोलू और श्यालू दो मूर्ख बकरियां थीं। एक दिन दोनों एक पुल को पार करने की कोशिश कर रही थीं। दोनों बीच पुल पर आकर टकरा कर रुक गईं, क्योंकि पुल बहुत छोटा था और केवल एक एक कर ही पुल को पार किया जा सकता था। लेकिन दोनों ही पुल को पहले पार करना चाहती थीं, इसलिए दोनों में लड़ाई छिड़ गई। दोनों मूर्ख बकरियां बीच पुल पर लड़ती रहीं और अंत में नदी में गिरकर डूब गईं।
Two silly goats. Gopu and Ramu were two silly goats. Both of them were trying to cross a bridge. They met in the middle of the bridge, which was so narrow that they could not pass each other. Now, each of them wanted to be the first to cross the bridge, so they began to fight. The silly goats kept on fighting till they both fell into the river and were drowned. Moral: foolishness is always punished.
What a foolishness! They could have passed the bridge safely by avoiding the fight.
You two must have learnt now. foolishness and foolish fights are always punished. Okay, kids, let's learn few new words one by one.
Kids, repeat the words after us. Narrow.
Narrow means not wide.
Narrow means not wide.
Drowned.
Drowned means killed by submerging in water.
Drowned means killed by submerging in water.
Now let me ask you a question. Where Gopu and Ramu fought?
On the narrow bridge.
But Surat pe ek hara bhara bada jungle tha. Us jungle mein bahut sare kai tarah ke ped the, jin mein aam, peepal, bargad, neem, shisham, tendu aadi the. Unme keval ek ped ka tana gathila aur buda hua tha. वो अन्य पेड़ों के बीच धब्बा सा लगता था। सारे पेड़ उसे बदसूरत कहकर उसका मजाक उड़ाते थे। बेचारे पेड़ ने सोचा, हे भगवान, आपने मुझे इतना बदसूरत क्यों बनाया? मैं क्यों नहीं बाकी पेड़ों की तरह हूँ? एक दिन एक लकड़हारा उस जंगल में आया। उसने उस गठीले पेड़ को देखकर सोचा, अरे अरे, ये पेड़ मेरे किसी काम का नहीं है। मैं बाकी के पेड़ों को काट लूंगा। फिर उसने उस गठीले पेड़ को छोड़कर सारे पेड़ों को काट लिया। अब उस पेड़ ने सोचा, भगवान जो भी करते हैं भले के लिए ही करते हैं। मेरी बदसूरती ने आज मेरी जान बचाई है। हमें अपनी परेशानियों के लिए ईश्वर को दोष नहीं देना चाहिए। उसके पीछे जरूर कोई ना कोई कारण होता है।
The ugly tree. Once upon a time, in a large forest, grew many different trees. There were mango, teak, oak, shisham, neem, banyan, and peepal trees. Amongst them, there was one tree that had a crooked trunk. It looked ugly compared to the other trees, and the other trees used to tease him.
You are an ugly tree, ugly tree, ugly tree. Oh no, you are such an ugly tree.
The poor tree was very sad.
Oh God, why did you make me ugly? Why am I not beautiful like the other trees?
One day, a woodcutter came to the forest. He saw the crooked and ugly tree.
This crooked tree is of no use to me. I will chop down the other straight trees.
He cut down all the trees except the crooked tree.
Thank God! My ugliness saved my life. We should never blame God for our troubles. God has a reason for everything.
Moral? Never blame God. There is always a reason behind His deeds.
Our lives are God's gift. He has created us with some qualities for some reason.
We should never be unhappy and curse God.
Okay, kids, let's learn few new words one by one.
Kids, repeat the words after us. Trunk.
Trunk means the main stem of a tree.
Trunk means the main stem of a tree.
Ugly.
Ugly means displeasing.
Ugly means displeasing.
Blame.
Blame means to hold responsible for something bad.
Blame means to hold responsible for something bad.
Why the tree was sad?
Because he was ugly.
Yes!